Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. Well, most of you probably know me. I'm Amos Lucidi. I'm the piano accompanist here at FUS, and this is my friend Ian Schneider, who, of course, is a violinist. You probably guessed that from his instrument. And we're here to present you a nice and varied program, and we wanted to thank everyone here at FUS for making this concert possible and for helping us out with everything. And Ian will tell you more about the program.
Thank you, Amos, and thank all of you for sharing the afternoon with us. We're really happy to have you here. Today is the first in a two-part series of music featuring LGBT composers. We're really excited to get to unearth kind of a new side of some familiar names, as well as to lift up some who you may not have heard of before. On the rear of your program booklet, there are some more detailed comments. I definitely encourage you to check it out. I think the thing that really struck me is that I thought that researching these composers was going to be very difficult and involve a lot of kind of nitty-gritty searching to get at what their lives are like. And when I started reading about them, it became apparent that they had very clear ideas of who they were, and the kind of life they were living, and they found quite a lot of ways to express it in their own time, even if it wasn't exactly what we think of outness as looking like today. So I feel as though I learned about as much about how we kind of swept things under the rug in the 20th century as I did about what their lives might have been like, a lot of 19th century music. I think in the process we've discovered Ethel Smyth is becoming a really interesting new name in classical music. New, she's been dead for quite a while, but and then Jennifer Higdon, if you are into classical music, she is a big name, and if you don't know her yet, maybe when she dies, you know, it'll be like the Impressionists, and the value of her work will go up a lot. So in any case, we're really glad that you're all joining us, and I hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all again for sharing your afternoon with us. We hope you're enjoying everything so far. I just want to make a couple acknowledgments. First of all, to FUS for this beautiful space, beautiful visually, beautiful acoustically. We're very grateful for their hospitality. The second you'll see in your program, this recital series is sponsored by Metropolitan Regional Arts Council. So you all voted for that, most likely. So thank you for that. And if you weren't in Minnesota, you know, back, I think they did it in 2010, if you've paid sales tax in the last few years, you've also contributed, so thanks very much. You know, part of this was that, you know, when you cook up a recital like this, you don't just want to play it once. You've got it all ready to go, and we wanted to make sure that it was accessible to the community, so we took it to two senior centers where folks might not ordinarily be able to make it out to concerts, and we're planning on doing so again and hoping to expand that with our spring cycle. So for anybody who feels that they're in a financial position to do so, if you'd like to support the continued accessibility of the concerts, we'd appreciate your generosity. There's a link in the program or a basket outside the doors. In any case, we're very grateful that you've shared your time with us. I think that's the most valuable resource of all, so really happy to have you all here. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.